Hey guys, how's it going? It's about second vote count, and we're just going to be doing a DPS guide now. This is going to be with this setup, this gear. Actually, I will go back to the bank and switch this out for a skirmisher of elements. But yeah, so this is just going to be a DPS guide. This is my way of DPSing. Some people have better ways of DPSing, I believe. I don't think this is the strongest way, however, if you're, you know, new to it and you're trying to learn a DPS rotation, this will be a decent one to follow. I haven't pulled too many max XP drops in P2 with it, but I've been pretty close, so other than that, if I don't pull max, I'm usually very, very close. But yeah, so I will see you guys in the kill. We're just getting ready and gearing all up right now. So yeah, I'll see you guys as soon as we start. Hey guys, so my team's here, so we're just starting it up now. Okay, so this is P1, the one with the jumper, as the other video shows that I'll be putting in today. Okay. A little technical difficulty here. alright, so we're all good now. So at the start of this phase, if you're 5-manning, you want a natural instinct. If you're 6-manning, you don't want it. Because natural instinct you just use as a way to not to deal more damage without having to use an adren pot. So we're just sunshining on this phase, and as soon as we get to the point where we can use threshold, so that's wild magic, asphyxiate, all that, we're going to go ahead and use those. And we'll just use magic tendrils here. Pop in one more dragon breath and a wild magic, and now we're building up to 100%, because when we go down to the last P2, sorry, we want to be definitely at 100%. So we're just going to pop on our shield right now so we can keep getting adren up. As you can see, I got to full adren and I was at 80 something. So at the end of this, we're just gonna, after his jump, no, don't wild magic. Oh no, oh god, that was bad. Oh god, that was really bad. Oh, we got back up to 100 anyway. Alright, so we're just keeping our shield on. I'm going to activate my aura now. I should have activated it then, but now it's fine as well. So the very start, what you want to do is use Metamorphosis, Adren Pot. Make sure you got your ring on, so you gain that 10% Adren. Wild Magic, Combust, use the abilities that deal more damage than Concentrated Blast and Rack. So after that's finished, and we'll throw in one deep impact here and one more attack, and we'll all be getting off, so we'll off now. I'm going to go into melee distance right now in Resonance. I got hit, so I'm getting out of melee distance now, because the reflect was on me, and as you saw there, he just grabbed the gravity ball. So at this part, you just go through all your thresholds. You should be able to do 2 rounds of all your thresholds, and you want to make sure that you're using Dragon Breath as much as possible. So go Wild Magic, Deep Impact, and throw in the Asphyxiate here. And we got one more attack till we got to get off. So we get off. Now we use Natural Instinct, and we use shield abilities, so Resonance, Preparation, Anticipate, Freedom. We'll hop back on now. And then when we get to 100%, we want to go into melee distance. Sunshine, get out of it. Get out of melee distance. Stay in your sunshine, of course. As soon as you get up to threshold, use wild magic. Then once you get to your next threshold again, use deep impact. And then your third threshold should be asphyxiate. And what you want to do now is get back up to at least 65 adren. So I'm at it right now. So it's got one more hit to get off, so I'll only be able to get the wild magic in. I won't be able to get the deep impact in as well. So we've got melee distance again, resonancing, preparation, anticipate, and freedom. Because I'm not taking fifth vogue, so I don't need freedom at all. And we'll be getting back on right now. And we'll go with an asphyxiate here. This one, what we're going to be doing is using metamorphosis when it comes up. So we're getting up to it now. I'm a bit late to it, but, you know, we'll still get it done. Oh, didn't get the ring swap. That's fine, though. As soon as you get to asphyxiate or wild magic, you want to be using those. I'll have enough time to fit this one in. And resonance, going to melee distance, or grab a bomb like I just did. And I'm just going to evoke it now just to get it over there quicker. So yeah, we're going to bring it down. Spam click, you know. Re-overload here. You don't have to right now. You can wait till you drop down, but I just do it now anyway. And we just... at this HP, how he's at this low HP, oh god, I hope people know what they're doing. Nah, he's reset. Damn. What happened there was his HP reset, and the reason for this was that people had their scrimshaws on while they were DPSing, and scrimshaws go through the damage reduction that Vorago does when you're bringing him down. So that's why he kept taking damage even though he's not supposed to be taking damage. So that's why you would have seen me turn off my scrim. So as you see just then, I pulled 23.5, I believe, which is pretty good. It's I wouldn't say it's the best, but obviously not the best, but it's pretty decent, I guess. So we're going down into P3. So this is where DPS really counts, and you do have to be on your ball with it. So we're going over to squares that are our colors, so green for green, red for red. And we're just going to be throwing in a wild magic, dragon breath, and then asphyxiate. And then when he does his third attack, you want to use another ability. Put your shield on. Resonance. Go into melee distance if your HP is low. In my case, I didn't need to, but... I'm just going to attack again because it's already came down. I'm going to go to red. And we put our Ring of Vigor on, and then we go Metamorphosis. Adren Pot. Switch back to our other ring. And this is the part where you want a wild magic. As soon as you get up to 50... use another ability, and asphyxiate when you get to asphyxiate, and then dragon breath out once you've done your hits, and then just continue to DPS. In this case, I'm going to surge so that I keep my adren up, and we're going to spam click right now, wild magic, dragon breath, deep impact, and asphyxiate, and we're going to get off now. Put our shield on, resonance, use preparation, anticipate, don't use, well I used freedom there, which is not good, but if I can get a hit in, which I just did, no, it's fine. I'm using surge just in this case, just to keep my adren from going down. So this is another DPS phase right now, I'm just going to be thresholding. I'm going to go ahead and walk it just to be sure. So what I'm doing right now is just walking it, so then it stops him from going into the next phase. That's usually the base does it, but I just wanted to do it then just to show you guys how to walk. So all you want to do is provoke it, turn your run off so you're always walking, and then once you go... once you evoke him, you like click somewhere on the map, like say for example if he was in the center, I'd walk through like this. And then you, after you determine which way he's moving, you can then walk in the direction he's walking with him, and since he walks at the same speed you do, you can make it so he doesn't attack anyone, because he's still provoked on you, he still has to target you. He does change targets, however, you can do that for a decent 10 seconds to stop the phase from continuing. So I got a mini right now, so I'm just going to put on Protect from Magic, because that's the style I'm using. And then use Devotion. Freedom if he stuns you. Get your Adrenaline up to 100% again. Slip back on the Soul Split. Green's under him. So we'll go into green. Use Anticipate. Click him once, sunshine, walk out of it, Adren pot. So we're going wild magic, dragon breath, chain, sacrifice, deep impact, then we'll be using combust and then asphyxiate. As soon as we come out of this asphyxiate, dragon breath to another chain, concentrated, and then wild magic, and then we should be off. That was clutch. So when you come out of this, you just want a wild magic, dragon breath, asphyxiate. You can deep impact before this, it doesn't really matter, but sometimes you may miss it. It's always better to use asphyxiate and then deep impact, in my opinion. I just remembered I still have my scrimshaw off. Might be good if I turn that on, eh? Oh, by wild magic. By accident. So what you would be doing here is going into melee distance, sunshining. We need to re-overload. I'm only going to get off an asphyxiate and a wild magic here, so I'm just going to do those two and get up to 100%. And we get off. So essentially how it works is, for people who don't know, and I'll be doing this in another video of like a overview of Vorago and how to do him. But it's three attacks after he does his five bleeds, so that's what I call, or it's known as, the Vokes. After the five Vokes happens, it'll be three attacks, and then he'll reflect. Which, for people who don't know, it's just, it reflects damage to a certain player. So if you dealt, I think it amplifies it as well, so if you dealt 6k damage, like with, say you had a Dragon Breath while it was reflecting and you dealt 6k damage, it wouldn't show up on Vorago, but it, the 6k damage, or it would go to 7k if it's amplified, I'm not too sure. Will go, if it was 5k damage, would go to 6k, and it gets put onto the other person who it was reflecting on. So at this start, we just wild magic and asphyxiate. Well, this is the third bomb now, so we need to get off. Use abilities. I just died. That's what happens if you don't get off on a reflect. Well, hold up, guys. I'll be back. I'll get back to the fifth phase. I'll show you that, guys, how to finish that. Okay, so we're back, and I have used freedom, so yeah, we're back in P5, guys. Hopefully I won't die right now. I'm just gonna res anyway, just to make sure. Okay, so in this phase you wanna meta, so we're gonna meta right now. with Dren Potting, auto attack once, then Dragon Breath. Wild Magic, your first priority. I need freedom, because I got a bleed. And now Asphyxiate, so we've used all three thresholds. Hopefully this will gain back at least another two. And he's about to go for another team split. So we gotta go to our allocated squares. If you're still in combat with him, what you can do is, once this finishes, you can just Wild Magic as you come out. As you see I just did then. So we got one more attack and then off. So we're off now. So I'm putting my shield on and using Resonance, because I might be the one who's getting reflected on, as you saw before, how I just got absolutely KO'd. So just keep using abilities. Now use a threshold right now because my ultimates aren't up. So Sunshine. I just stood in melee distance like a goof. And my overload ran out. That ain't the best. I was kind of rushed for this, so that's why my stuff isn't all ready. Even my teammates telling me to stay out of melee distance. Oh god. So once the team split happens, where you get put into the boxes or you're a certain color, it's three mage bombs or three melee hits. It can be either or. So it could be two mage balls. I just got a bleed on me, so I'm gonna freedom that. I got a second bleed, so I'm gonna surge back. And if I get another one, do I get another one? Oh no, it was already. So we go greens at the front. You're red, chief. You're red! Oh god, that was close. So I'm going to put our shield on right now because some mage bomb might be coming in. Oh, I did not resonance that. And we'll get off now because that's the bomb for the reflect. Just keep using abilities, so except for freedom, just so we stay in combat. Oopsie, put my ring back on one more time. There we go. Dren Pot. Wild Magic when we get to it. Then Chain. Do one more Dragon Breath. And Asphyxiate. This should be it. There we go. So basically what you want to do is either Sunshine or Meta. I prefer Meta, but you can Sunshine. You use that when reflects, after the reflect happens. So the reflect is after team split, it'll be three mage bombs, and then you'll go to, then after the three mage bombs, it'll be reflect, there'll be another three attacks, and then, that's when you sunshine, as I would have shown just then. The best thing to do is sunshine altogether. You kind of want to do it because of the way, Vorago works in that last phase. The more damage you put out all at once, the better. So yeah. So thanks guys. But yeah. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys all have a wonderful day. And if you need any help in game, or you can see anything in this video that could have been helpful to anyone else, please mention it in the comments, so then I can other people who are going through can see it, and then they'll know that that's what they need to do if there was something that I could have done better. So yeah guys, have a good one.